Hello.
Hello.
On a visit to the GSI in Darmstadt, Germany, physicist Robert Kaderka from the biophysics department shows us how heavy ions from an accelerator can be used to destroy brain tumors. To date, only a few centers worldwide possess this capability. Kaderka is now working on extending this principle to other types of cancer.
The body has several control mechanisms to prevent that cells grow unlimited. One of these mechanisms is the so-called apoptosis. This is the programmed cell death, where a cell can tell its surroundings that I'm going to die because of DNA misfunctions or something else. But this process is disturbed in cancer cells. This means that a cancer cell can grow unlimited. The aim of radiotherapy is to reinitiate this process, so we use the ion beam or photon beams in general to produce large DNA damages, so the cell starts first to not divide anymore and later to go into apoptosis.
Ion radiation therapy has decisive advantages. In the accelerator, carbon atoms are brought to up to 75% of the speed of light and then directed to the place of therapy. The scientists tune the speed of the ion so that they can penetrate all the way to the tumor. Along the way, the ions are decelerated. When they are reduced to a certain speed, the ions draw in a significant number of electrons. In this way, the DNA of the cancer cells is irreparably damaged. This makes ion therapy unique in that healthy tissue is hardly damaged. To reach all the cells, the biophysicists measure the tumor exactly and divide it into layers digitally. The ion beam can be positioned with millimeter accuracy and can thus be driven through the layers point by point, destroying the tumor cells along the way. A mask is used to prevent the patient from moving so that the ion beam does not hit spots outside of the tumor area. 440 patients, mostly with brain tumors, have been successfully irradiated at the GSI by this method. In the future, it should also be possible to treat lung tumors.
One group at GSI is dedicated to the treatment of moving tumors, and one of the main moving tumors is lung tumors, which where the tumor is attached to the lung tissue, and when you breathe, the lung tumor will move along with the breathing.
To study how one may treat moving tumors, the GSI scientists have developed a model rib cage. With this, they can test how the ion beam may target the tumor at any time, even though it is moving due to the breathing process.
So what you can see here is a thorax with a skin. It's got several bones inside, and it's attached via some strings to this electromotor. And when this motor is moving, the strings are pulled, so the thorax is pulled down, so it basically breathes. And attached to this robotic arm is this PMMA plate, which at the end has a cube, which simulates our lung tumor.
Measuring devices are placed inside the artificial tumor to record whether the beam actually arrives at the spot where it is supposed to destroy the harmful tumor cells. Currently, scientists are testing how one can measure the movement of the tumor during the irradiation.
One of the possibilities is to put little markers on the skin, which can be captured with a camera system. And the camera system then recognizes in which phase of breathing is the thorax, and therefore can know, okay, he's just at exhale, then therefore the tumor must be at a certain position and tells the magnets to steer the beam to that position.
The results are currently being evaluated. The scientists are confident that their procedure works.